A proton blast from the Shander Mining Company explodes out the top of a mine shaft into a swirling cloud vortex in the pre-title sequence. Then an ancient pickup vehicle pulls out of the mine pit and begins to travel down a lonely country road. Oliver Cooper, the truck's driver, is an elderly guy with a beard who is hidden in the cabin's darkness. He touches a ghost trap containing a spirit while looking down at the passenger seat. An unknown entity is pursuing his truck and eventually manages to sideswipe it and send it tumbling into a cornfield. In front of an old farmhouse, in an open field, the man falls outside. When he reaches the porch, he turns back and holds up the baited trap for the ghost in the cornfield. Egon Spengler, the elderly guy, is preparing a foot pedal switch while invisible footsteps advance across the field. Egon steps on the pedal once it is in place, and many electric towers start to turn on. However, they brief out before turning on the appliance they were meant to power, so Egon hastily enters and closes the door. He positions himself on a chair with his PKE meter before concealing the trap in a space beneath the wood floor. His PKE starts to light up and its arms start to expand as fog begins to cover the space, giving the impression that a ghost is there. The PKE meter drops to the ground and turns off when Egon is attacked while sitting in his chair. From outside, a spirit orb can be seen departing the building. The PKE meter activates once more inside the house, signifying a fresh ghost nearby. As Callie, Carrie Coon, Trevor, Finn Wolfhard, and Phoebe, McKenna Grace, are being evicted from their flat, we first meet them. When Callie learns that her father has died in his farmhouse in Oklahoma, she gathers everything of worth, including the house, and brings the kids along. They come across a run-down, cluttered home. They are exploring when Janine, the Ghostbusters receptionist, enters and informs them that Callie's father, Egon, had a deplorable farm and a mountain of debt. The family hides under a table as the ground starts to tremble in what seems to be earthquake disturbances. When her grandfather passed away, Phoebe noticed the PKE meter underneath the chair. After telling Trevor and Phoebe they will be staying there for some time while she decides what to do, Callie takes them into town for dinner. It turns out to be a tiny southern hamlet where everyone knew about the enigmatic man they all referred to as the dirt farmer because there was no proof he had ever grown any crops. Due of his crush on Lucky, the restaurant's employee, Celeste O'Connor, Trevor applies for a job there. Phoebe uses the PKE meter to start exploring the farm in the days that follow. She makes a move from her side of the board after noticing a chess board with an opening move. As Callie leaves Phoebe off at summer school, she runs into her instructor Gary, Paul Rudd. Gary only works there to be paid, and he sits in the back conducting research on the continuous earthquakes in the region while the youngsters watch VHS tapes of classic horror films, starting with Cujo, 1983. He is impressed by Phoebe's expertise in seismology, and he informs her that the tremor wave patterns don't like those of normal historical earthquakes. Additionally, Phoebe meets Logan Kim, a student in her class who calls himself Podcast because he is constantly using his microphone to capture material for his show. The chess pieces start moving in front of Phoebe as she starts playing the ghost at the farmhouse after noticing that another move has been made on the board. By turning on lights, the ghost guides her downward till she discovers the ghost trap hidden beneath a floor panel. She gives it to Gary, who describes what it is in light of his familiarity with the infamous New York siege of 1984. He plays old YouTube clips of the Ghostbusters commercial for her and podcast. To get the trap to open, they attach it to the batteries of a school bus. They are successful, and a ghost that resembles one of the original demon canines flees. As Trevor discovers Ecto, one in the barn covered by a tarp, and Phoebe discovers Egon's lab in the cellar, revelations are made. Realizing that their grandfather was a Ghostbuster, they both decide to act independently. With the assistance of Egon's ghostly ghost, Phoebe fixes a proton blaster and tests it while podcast watches. They fire it, and a rustling comes from a neighboring warehouse. The metal-eating ghost known as Muncher is discovered. They make an unsuccessful attempt to wrestle and grab him. In the meantime, Trevor fixes Ecto-1 and goes for a joyride in it. While on the ride, he meets Phoebe and Podcast, who explain what they were up to. To capture Muncher, the team launches Ecto-1. They pursue him through the city, using the proton gun to obliterate loads of property. Egon's mounted ghost trap on an RC car helps them catch it. They were stopped and taken to the town's holding cell after the police were notified by the chaos. Phoebe calls the Ghostbusters number from the commercial while they are in jail using her one phone call option. Ray Stantz responds and tells that the group split up after purportedly getting rid of all the ghosts. After Egon stole all of their tools and said Gozer could still bring about the end of the world, he and Egon fell out. When Phoebe is about to tell him that Egon was killed a week ago, the sheriff unexpectedly cuts her off, saying her phone time is up. They get bailed out when Callie and Gary, who were out on a date at the time, arrive. Phoebe confronts her mother for withholding the identity of their real grandfather. Callie responds with her relationship with her father in the past. She didn't share his interest in science and thought he didn't care about her. She also felt that they never connected. He moved away from them and established himself as a recluse on the Oklahoma farm, she reasoned. The kids discover in their grandfather's lab that his dirt farm was actually a field of thousands of ghost traps intended to capture Gozer, because they believe there must be a reason their grandfather would give up everything to live on a farm in the middle of nowhere. They proceed to reinspect the mine shaft after realizing that his trap must have failed. By this time, Lucky and Trevor had grown close as a result of Lucky's employment and the revelation that she is the sheriff's daughter. She goes to the mine with Podcast, Phoebe, and Trevor as a result. They learn that the mine is a conduit to the wicked dead, which is the cause of all the tremors. As a result, every time Gozer summons the twin demon hounds and the horde of ghosts, for seismically activated proton weapons Egon installed within start firing. They automatically cross beams and stifle the ghosts' persistent attempts to flee. Everyone in the community was suffering frequent tremors because of this, and the only thing stopping Gozer was the impossible task Egon had taken on by himself, because no one else believed him. After his strange date with Callie that night, Gary visits Walmart to buy some ice cream. He finds many miniature Stay Puft Marshmallow Men running around the store like a swarm of gremlins and spreading havoc. He encounters the demonic dog he earlier released, is chased to his car, and is then mauled, precisely like in the Cujo incident. When Callie returns to the farmhouse, she unearths the secret lab and learns that her father Egon had a memory board of her entire life up on the wall. The other demon dog finds her in the lab and takes possession of her just as she begins to understand how much he really cared for her. When the kids return home to tell Callie about their finding, they discover that she is possessed and that she has jumped out of the window and is running towards the mine pit. When Gary is located, the ghosts have already begun to flee after he destroyed the autoproton weapons that were keeping them at bay. In the mine, the two merge energy. With Lucky's assistance, the kids retrieve Ecto-1 from the police impound. By reaching inside the weapon-holding cage and freeing Muncher, who instantly chews away the bars and escapes, Phoebe and Podcast are able to remove the RC ghost trap and proton blaster from the container. When they get to the mine, they see Gary and Callie changing into the demon dog shapes, with Gozer sitting in the middle of them. Phoebe emerges from hiding to converse with and divert Gozer, and Podcast manages the RC trap to catch the demon dog that is possessed Callie. As she collapses, this allows her to escape her canine shape. Callie joins the kids as they flee in Ecto-1 from Gary, who is still pursuing them in dog shape. They travel to the farmhouse and try to catch Egon in the same trap. On the porch, Callie and Phoebe are carrying the spirit trap and the demon dog that Gozer requires in order to fully resurrect himself. Phoebe tries to set the traps off when Gozer emerges from the cornfield, but they fall off once more, just like they did with Egon at first. Gozer is able to free the demon dog from the ghost trap thanks to several small Stay Puft Marshmallow guys sabotaging Ecto-1's machinery. Lucky is the dog that was set free. Phoebe is struck by a proton blast from behind just as Gozer, who is now at full strength, is ready to murder her. It's Ray Stantz, who had just gotten here with Winston Zeddemore and Peter Venkman. Crossing the beams, the three original Ghostbusters shoot at Gozer. She presents as subdued, but as soon as she starts to uncross the beams, she blasts the Ghostbusters back, causing them to all fall to the ground. Peter humorously laments their relationship's inherent problems as Gozer approaches them. She is once more taken prisoner by a single proton beam just as she gets to them. This time, Phoebe is the one whose goal is being directed by Egon's ghost. The audience sees his face for the first time at this point. Jumping up, the other three Ghostbusters join the conflict by launching their own beams. Gozer is once more repressed but not captured by the combined power of the four beams. Trevor can now exit Ecto-1 and launch his proton beam at the electrical capacitors because he and Podcast have defeated the mini-puffs and fixed the damaged machinery. They are energized by the energy rush. Callie flips the switch once more to try to set the traps off, and this time they work, catching Gozer and the demon hounds. The ghostly appearance of their slain buddy astounds the remaining three original Ghostbusters. They watch as he bids Callie farewell, fixes her glasses, which are identical to his, and says goodbye. Egon's form disappears into the night sky after he made peace with his family. Before Winston promises them that he will restore Ecto-1, and the three remaining original Ghostbusters take it and their equipment back to New York City, Lucky and Gary escape from the frozen dog corpses, and the three remaining original Ghostbusters get to know the Spenglers. As the Ghostbusters theme music starts, we see an aerial image of Ecto-1 going across a bridge in New York City while equipped with emergency lights. The same pattern cards and electroshock device that Peter Venkman used in his university research before becoming a Ghostbuster are used by Dana Barrett Venkman, Sigourney Weaver, to test Peter Venkman's psychic abilities in a mid-credits scene. In a post-credits scene, Winston, who is now the wealthy head of his family, speaks briefly with Janine and mentions that he has been using his resources to maintain the Ghostbusters properties, including the ghost. Winston then opens the fire station entrance so Ecto-1 can be driven back inside, and then we see a shot of the containment system in the basement with a blinking red light. Please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.